We are all used to communicating with our colleagues about our research, whether at informal lab meetings, in the form of lectures or poster presentations at conferences, or of course, in peer-reviewed papers in scientific journals. But how does science communication, particularly with non-expert audiences, actually work? Here are five important aspects worth thinking about before any kind of communication, especially if you want to communicate with target groups beyond your own colleagues. What is my aim? Who is my target audience? Which medium or channel should I use? What is the right communication style? And what is the actual topic I want to communicate? These five aspects form the basis of successful science communication. We have summarized them in the form of an arrow. All five elements of this arrow, aim, target audience, medium, communication style, and topic, are important. And although they need to be considered separately, they often influence one another. Let me give you an example to illustrate how you can use this arrow and how these five elements are connected. I've been at multiple dinner parties and family gatherings where someone, for instance, my uncle, has asked, "So what is your PhD about?" I'm sure most of you have been in a similar situation. And unless your relative is an expert in your field, they're not really going to care about your latest exciting results. And so you've established the first thing, your communication style. In this case, it is avoiding technical language. Your target audience is, of course, your uncle. And your topic is your research. The medium here is a simple verbal conversation where questions can be asked and possibly even a dialogue. And finally, your aim. It could be that you want to satisfy the curiosity of your uncle, or maybe you want to express enthusiasm about your own research topic. Or perhaps you want to attempt to explain the fact that your doctorate will take a little bit longer than planned. Let's consider another example. Suppose you are working on a proposal for your next research project, and your funder requires you to develop a communication strategy to disseminate your project results, your topic. The aim is to reach a wider audience and to achieve more impact. In this case, you could start by identifying who your target audience and stakeholders are, and then decide the best ways to reach them. For example, which media platform do they predominantly use? You should then prepare your topics in the style that is most appropriate for your target audience, as well as the respective medium. For Instagram, this would probably mean using photos or short video clips. Or for Twitter, it's short sentences and so on. As you can see, the NaWik arrow is an incredibly versatile tool for science communication. But missing just one of the five building blocks means that your entire communication might break down. So remember to take them all into account. Have a clear aim. Consider your target audience. Choose a suitable medium. Adjust your communication style. And be clear about your topic, what you actually want to say. Hopefully, you are now well equipped to effectively talk about your research to audiences ranging from teenagers on TikTok to grant proposals at work.